serve, I serve. If this life I lose, I will follow you.
Welcome, everyone. Thanks for joining us. We're in the middle of a series entitled Small Words, Big Meaning. And we're talking about words that we may hear or read often, but not really give much thought to. If you didn't catch the past 2 weeks, we talked about two very powerful but small words, and go. Today, we're going to dig into a word that's a bit longer, but doesn't necessarily always have positive connotations. How many of us have heard, don't be a follower, be a leader, or don't follow that person or trend, or why do you follow when you can lead? Yet Jesus tells us a very different story about the word follow, and I'm excited for you to hear about it. Thanks again for being here.
I'll start with probably one of the most famous lines in the Bible, and that's when Jesus said to his disciples, you know, follow me. So Jesus wants to lead us. He wants us to follow him. But the world around us likes to not, you know, allow us. They don't want us to follow anyone. They want us to be driven. So the culture of this earth, you know, the evil spirits, the prince of the air, whatever you want to call it, will push you to become very aggressive to acquire things, to make you very driven. But God doesn't want us to do that. He wants us to follow him, to yield to his yoke. He said in Matthew that his yoke was easy and the burden was light. When you think of follow versus driven, you understand that there are certain animals that will not be led. You have to get behind them and you have to really drive them, but lambs will be led. You know, lambs are led, they're not driven. And Jesus used this analogy as another way to talk to us about being led and letting him lead us. So he said, you know, I am the good shepherd and my sheep know my voice. And that's why he used that analogy. He wanted us to understand that he was leading us, he was the shepherd, and if we followed him, he would protect us. He went on to say that the story of the shepherd with 100 sheep and one of them was lost, and he said that if a shepherd has 100 sheep and one of them is lost, that the shepherd would leave the 99 behind to go get the lost sheep. He wouldn't just leave that sheep. And when he found the lost sheep, he would pick him up and carry him back. So Jesus is trying to tell us there that he's going to lead us, that the yoke is easy, the burden is light, and we don't have to worry about getting lost. He's got the path figured out for us. And, you know, the another thing about following someone is that the leader is the one that really takes on the danger. So when you're following Jesus, he's in the lead, and he's also able to protect you from things that you may not see. Because he's God, and you know, God knows everything, and God is always right, and we're not God, and we're not always right. So that's part of why he wants us to follow us, because he is good and he wants to protect us. But the thing we have to always be aware of is that Satan, who's the prince of the air and the ruler of this world, you know, he is driven. You can read through the Bible and you can tell he's very driven. And he understands that if he can get us driven, that we're going to be out of our element, because that's not how God made us. When he made humankind, he didn't make us to be driven. He made us to follow his will, to listen to his voice. And he said, my sheep hear my voice. But one of the ploys of the enemy is to get you driven, worried, anxious, living in fear, living in doubt, uptight, all those kinds of things. Those are not things that are from God. God does not have worry and anxiety and fear to hand out to anyone. But you know, that's what Satan wants us to do. But if we resist Satan and we don't go there, then he can't win, because he only has as much power as we will yield to him. And because we have to remember always that Satan is a defeated foe. In 1 John it says that Jesus defeated the works of the devil and he made a show of him openly. So Satan is defeated already by the blood of Jesus. He's been defeated. In the book of James, it says, if we submit ourselves to God and we resist the devil, he will flee from us. So submit ourselves to God, yield to his will, yield to put on his yoke, and then resist the devil means push back, you know, push the devil back with the word of God. when we follow the Lord, so we can expect, you know, many good things. And there's so much through the scriptures, but I like to talk about Psalm 139 because it's, I just think it's so descriptive and how it talks about what the Lord really wants for us. So in verse 5 in Psalm 139, it says, "You've gone into my future to prepare the way, and in kindness you follow behind me to spare me from the harms of my past." And I just think that's amazing if you think about it. It's that Jesus has paved a way for you, and he's standing in your future, and he's bidding you to come to him. And then out of his love for you, he's gone behind you to protect you from the harms of your past. So he's got this great plans for you. He's already, you know, beaten the trail down for you. And he's saying, come on, I've got this. Follow me. And don't worry about anything from your past. It's not going to hurt you because I'm a warrior. Remember, our Lord is a warrior and he's going to protect you from it. If you keep reading there, it gets even better. I think in verse 16, it says, "You saw who you created me to be before I became me. Before I'd ever seen the light of day, the number of days you planned for me were already recorded in your book." So God sat on his throne, and then he thought of you, and he knew what he wanted you to be, and he wrote this beautiful book about you with all these amazing things that you're going to do in your life. In order to know what's in your book, all you have to do is agree, you know, accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior, and agree and accept his perfect will for your life. And he is going to lead you into it. Remember, God sings songs of deliverance over you. He wants you to fall into the plans that he has for you and let him lead you into them. So one of the things I like to do every morning is I like to just say, you know, Jesus, I accept your perfect will for me, and I am so excited about what it is you have planned for me. I tell him, you know, I'm fully ready to cooperate with you and the angels that you've sent to help guide me, because I know you've sent them because you said that you would send angels to help me. You know, he only has good things if we, you know, there's so many scriptures about this, but like the book of James in chapter 1, it says every good gift and every perfect gift is from above. So again, you can expect that when you are following and letting the Lord lead you, that he's going to give you good gifts and perfect gifts. That's what he is. He's a good father. In Matthew 25, it says, "Before him all the nations will be gathered, and he will separate them one from another, just as a shepherd separates the sheep from the goats." So there's goats. Those are animals that are not going to be led. You know, they're very stubborn, and anyone that knows goats is going to know that a goat is just going to plow through and do things their own way. But a sheep will wait for the good shepherd to lead them. You know, we could go on. 2 Peter chapter 1 is really an amazing scripture that I don't hear preached on very often or spoken about. But it says, "Therefore, brethren, be even more diligent to make your calling and election sure. For if you do these things, you will never stumble." So God not only has great plans for you, he's paved a way for you. He's going to protect you from the harms of your past. But if you follow him, you will never stumble. You will never stumble. You know, according to 2 Peter, at least that's what it says. So just, you know, when you think of the word follow, you just have to remember that you have a wonderful Heavenly Father. You know, God is a good God. He is a good Father. He only thinks good thoughts about you. He wrote a beautiful book about you. He has all these amazing things planned for you, things that you are so wonderful you probably couldn't even imagine them, you know, if you sat and thought about it. He's not mad at you. He'll never hurt you. He's standing in your future. He wants you to submit yourself to him. He wants to protect you. And he's standing in your future, and he's just saying, come to me. I am your good, good father, and I love you, and I'm here to help you. So that's when I think of the word follow in relation to our Heavenly Father and the scriptures. That's what I think of. So have a great evening. Thanks for listening.
Well, I want to thank Michele for her message tonight and for her sharing with us. I want to also continue to thank the congregation for your continued support of our Saviors and our ministry in this place. Let us pray. Gracious God, we give you thanks that Jesus lifts up following as a mark of discipleship. Lord, we don't always think of following as being a positive thing, but Lord, when we're following you, that changes everything. Lord, help us to see the benefit in following you. Lord God, we lift up before you tonight those who are in special need. We pray tonight especially for Roma Solberg and Steve Gardsky, for Jeannie Penchinski, and for Roger Youngquist. And Lord, for all of those who are suffering in body, mind, or spirit, continue to pray for those suffering from the coronavirus, for all of the healthcare workers and first-line workers, for those doing research, and ask that a vaccine and a treatment might be sped. Lord, we pray for all those who are out of work or furloughed or for businesses that are suffering, and we remember those who are in economic need. And we ask too, Lord, that you would provide daily bread for them. We continue to pray, Lord, that you would continue to bless us as we seek to find our way in this time. Bless families as they adjust to new schedules. Bless students as they try to finish out the year. We ask for your presence with graduating seniors and finding work. Lord, you know the needs of your people. Come now and provide. We ask this in Jesus' name, who taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Receive the benediction. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. In the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Savior, I come, quiet my soul, remember, redemption's here, your blood was spilled for my ransom. Everything I want held dear, I count it all as lost. Lead me to the cross where your love poured out. Bring me to my knees, Lord, I lay me down. Lead me in my sin.